Hello, I'm Father Brian DeLessi, coming to you from the chapel of Kennedy Catholic High School. This year, the Pope has promulgated a year of faith, where he wants us to renew our understanding of the documents of Vatican II, or the Second Vatican Council. In this brief little discussion, I just wanted to discuss the document of the Dogmatic Constitution on the Church, which is also known as Lumen Gentium. It's how we understand and see the Church in the world. It's a very important document for us, especially as Catholics, because it helps us to view ourselves in relationship to Christ and the world. The document is extensive, but it covers some main themes. First, that the Church is a mystery. It's a mystery of how the risen Christ continues his mission in the life of the Church in the world, how we're called to cooperate with that mission, how we're a pilgrim people, growing in holiness and being utilized by the Holy Spirit to pronounce the message of the gospel to all people. The first is that, and then after the Church's mystery, it's that the Church is also the people of God, that together through our baptism we're called to serve as priest, prophet, and king. The priestly office is to offer prayers and intercession for the needs of the world. The prophetic office is to witness to the faith, primarily through our lives and by inviting others to consider the faith. And then the royal office, king or queen, is to rightly order our own lives and the world, to be able to promote that, really the invitation of grace in the life of the world. Then after the understanding of the Church's mystery and then the Church as the people of God, we look at our relationship to other Christians and other people of other religions. This is important because we believe that to be part of the Church is not even necessarily just to be part of the explicit Catholic Church, but we share in a common baptism with our other Christian brothers and sisters and participate on a certain level of what it means to be the body of Christ. There's also a movement as well, even outside the Church, that the document speaks about, that the Holy Spirit moves in all people and draws them to unity, draws them to God, that the Catholic Church doesn't have a monopoly upon the Holy Spirit, that the Spirit can move where it wills. After the understanding of the Church's mystery and the Church as the people of God, the document continues on to speak about the different layers of the Church, starting with the bishops and their shepherding role and how they're called to serve the Church. Then moving as well into religious life, how there's called to be a renewal of the original foundations of the charisms of those in religious life, as well as the ministry and the role of the lay people to sanctify the world, to transform the structures of society. The Church as well is called in Lumen Gentium to be a people that promote dignity of all human people in the life of the world. And Lumen Gentium itself, the structure of the document, is actually played out in a number of the other documents in the life of Vatican II, which we'll cover in more detail. It gives the highlights, and then the other documents take specific aspects of that to explain them even more so. Lumen Gentium, an extremely important document in Vatican II, about how we understand ourselves as the Church in relationship to the world. More to come. God bless.